Hello. Today, I will introduce how to create and use your own addon in SPUM with your own design. On the screen right now, we have a Korean Joseon Dynasty armor and costume created for SPUM in collaboration with our designer. It's beautifully made, isn't it? I will show you the process of creating this costume as a SPUM addon. What you need to check here are the clothing part, the shoes part, and then the armor part, as shown on the screen. You should create image files for these three parts with specific intervals for proper use in SPUM. First, go to SPUM, click on the SPUM tab at the top, and select Create Addon Folder Structure. A pop-up called Folder Cloner will appear, and from there, click on Quick Create. Then, a success pop-up will appear, and the addon structure will be preset. Depending on your needs, you can add or remove items, but it's recommended to use the basic structure. In the New Addon section, please enter the name of your addon. I will create a folder named kh_chosen. Once the name is decided, click Create Folder Structure at the bottom to create the folder. Now, you can see that a folder named kh_chosen has been created in SPUM's resource folder under addon. And within that folder, you'll find the unit, horse, and prefab folders, matching the structure we just created. In the unit sprite section, you will find the areas where we need to add our images. Now, distribute the prepared images into these areas. Clothing goes into the cloth section, helmets go into the helmet section, feet go into the pounce section, and armor goes into the armor section. If you go into each folder, you will see that the image sprites are placed there. These images are not currently in sprite structure. They are just texture images to use them in SPUM. You need to convert them to sprites in Unity format. The first thing you need to change is the texture type. By default, change it to sprite. Next, there is the sprite mode for images that have three or two parts, like clothes, pants, and armor, select multiple. And for one-part images, like helmets, select single. Since this is the clothing section, select multiple. In SPUM, the pixels per unit is set to 32. And at the bottom, in the filter mode, change it to point, since it's a pixel image. You can adjust the default image to your settings, but for the best design results, set the size to 128 and the compression to none, and click Apply. Now, you can see that the image has been changed. Make sure to apply the same changes to the other parts. For helmets, since it's a single image, select single. For armor, since it's divided into three parts, keep multiple selected and adjust the settings. Now the basic sprite conversion is done, and each image needs to be divided into parts. Select the image and click Open Sprite Editor in the Inspector tab. If this window doesn't open, you need to install the 2D package in Unity. Open the Package Manager in Windows. The screen shown is based on Unity 6, so it may look different depending on the Unity version you're using. To enable 2D sprite editing, install the 2D section from the Unity registry. Once 2D sprite editing is available, you'll see the images with proper pixelation, as shown here. Now, each part needs to be divided. In the current version of SPUM, parts are separated using naming conventions, so make sure to name each part correctly. For the center part, name it body. For the right arm, right. And for the left arm, left. This is important for SPUM to load it properly. Don't forget to click Apply at the top to apply the changes. For pants, there are only two parts, so just name them left and right. Be mindful of case sensitivity when naming. For helmets, since it's a single image, there's no need to change the selection area. For armor, name the parts right, body, and left. Now, the basic preparations for SPUM. Next step is to set up the pivot points for SPUM. In the SPUM folder, there's a folder called Sprite Editor Beta. Select this folder and run the SPUM_SpriteEditor scene. The basic structure will appear as shown. Go to the Scene tab, not the Game tab, and you will see each part displayed like this. Switch to 2D view. By selecting the gizmos named according to each part, you can see the actual positions of the parts. The points represent pivot points for animation, and there are image parts where the actual images are placed under the p_part. When you select an image part, you'll see a component called Sprite Sync. You need to match the images we will add to the now sprite in this component. Let's proceed together. Now, let's go back to the kh_chosen folder we created earlier, and start by placing the clothing. Since the clothing is a multiple sprite, it is divided into three parts. To place the clothing, select the body part on the image. There are two main parts for the body. One is the clothing part, and the other is the body armor. Choose the cloth body part, and you'll see that the sprite sync part is empty. Drag the body image and place it there. Now you'll see the image placed on the screen, and three buttons will appear. If you click Remove Sprite, you can delete the image again. By moving the part on the screen and placing it at the desired point, click Sync Pivot to adjust the sprite pivot points in Unity to match the position. If you want to create a new pivot, click Reset Pivot. Now, let's do the same for the arms. LC Arm refers to the left arm, so move the left part and place it where you want, then click Sync Pivot. For the right arm, move the right part, place it according to the design, and click Sync Pivot. Let's try the pants now. The foot part is located at the bottom, and there are corresponding parts, so place the right leg at the r_cloth part, and the left leg at the l_cloth part, then sync the pivots. Next, let's work on the helmet. The helmet will be placed on the head part. The helmet has two images in SPUM. There's a basic front garnish available, so there's also a helmet too. Since it's not being used right now, place it on the helmet 1 pivot point. After dragging and placing the image, you might see it appear in the wrong position, but after adjusting it and clicking Sync Pivot, it will be properly placed. Next, let's place the armor since the helmet is in the way. We cannot see the armor position correctly, so click Remove Sprite to temporarily remove it. Now, let's place the armor. This part goes into the body armor section, not the cloth body, part we saw earlier, so select that part. Now, go to the armor section and drag the body part into the slot to place it. After placing it appropriately, click Sync Pivot. The shoulder part is labeled as shoulder. Since the shoulder part is different from the clothing, you need to position it accordingly. Select l_shoulder and adjust its position according to the design, then click Sync Pivot. Do the same for the right shoulder, adjusting it to match the design, and click Sync Pivot. Now, the basic sprite image setup and pivot point configuration are complete. Next, let's go back to the SPUM scene. We're going to try using the custom addon we created. Since new data has been added, select the SPUM manager and click Regenerate Data and Load Packages. This will update the internal data. Now, let's press play. You will see that the addons we added to each part are now included. The kh_chosen appears. Select the helmet. Select the clothing. Select the pants. Select the armor. One of the advantages of SPUM is that you can combine it with existing resources. So by adding a bow to the back, a sword in hand, and a shield, a cool Korean unit is created. You can even mount a horse. When riding a horse, you can adjust it so the weaponry is displayed clearly. And thus, the majestic cavalry is complete. By using the addon feature provided by SPUM, you can easily create your own addon sets. This feature is still being improved. So if new features are added, creating your own addons will be much easier once the new features are developed. I'll introduce them to you. This concludes today's video. Thank you.